If you're going from here to there, what do you do to get there?
Oh yes, that's. I make in class small, short phrases, which have to do with speed and clarity. And it may involve a complex rhythmic thing, or less complex, but how what that is. That they have to know. At the end point, do you bring your heels together or are they separate? Is one exactly what it is? Because otherwise, it's like a garbled sentence where you only heard one or two words in it. Performing is a point when all your senses and your skill or whatever can come together. They don't always do that, but they can. And I think something that makes a performer interesting on the stage or wherever is that he or she is extremely conscious of exactly what they're doing as they are doing it, at the same time they are being free. I remember her, she was in a workshop I gave in San Francisco at, I think it was Marvin Jenkins' studio. And I thought that she was somewhat awkward in the way she moved. But at the same time, each thing she did, she clearly thought about how to figure out how to do this or that or get from here to there. The result is she was interesting to watch.
To get from here to there, there's a very articulated set of moves you're doing, no more, no less. It's completely functional to get from here to there. My name is Elizabeth Streb, and the first time I saw Merce's work was in the late 70s, early 80s. And I went to BAM, I believe, or even maybe it was Nazareth College up in Rochester. I can't quite remember where it was. It was on a proscenium stage. And it was when I realized that was a technique I wanted to study, that was the only rigor, in my opinion, then, it was the only rigorous technique that modern dance had to offer. And I think it had to do with rhythms, because I think in temporality, rhythmic issues are where the deep intelligence lies. I think rhythm is, if it's profound rhythm, it grabs the body by the gut and the heart and circumvents the brain. So that kind of attention getting, which is what I think Merce's work does. Within the notion of Merce, yes, he's right side up. Yes, his base is mostly the bottoms of the feet. Yes, he's dancing. Not in the way musical people dance, but in the way brilliant temporal geniuses dance. And he's piercing the space with the bodies of his dancers. He's piercing the space with these spatial interrupters. And if you think of his visual spatial compilations, he's reinventing how space gets divided by how he's instructing his dancers to move in time.
You learn some kind of technique, and in acting or in dancing,
then you apply it, and you say you're in a dance company, and you apply what you know, but very often the choreographer gives something that you don't, that's not familiar to you.
Jump the last one, one and two, ah, bah. You may have to hold a little bit, that's all right. Here, so close your foot quickly. One and two, up and down, okay? One and two and three, go, and yup, up, down, here. Up. Come on, let's do it again now. When you close your foot, really push off of both feet. Don't let your front heel be up. Really get, so you push from that foot, both from both. Okay, once more. One, two, three, go.
It's the way you dance that's going to be what the experience is. You've gotten all this from the teacher or somebody else, but you have to take that and turn it into something that's alive for you. Not to change it, but to really, it's trying to do as accurately as possible, because out of that accurate attempt at accuracy, you find something else. Regardless of complexity or simplicity, it has to look real, is the only word I can again think of. Not as though you're imitating some step.
I remember Merce saying something to the effect that if you pay attention and you know so clearly what you're doing, and this is where I think I'm not sure if the human's capable of this. If you are so clearly articulate about your steps and your movements and your rhythms, and you are at the same time 110% present, it will be new each time. I think that what we do have in common, what Merce and I might have in common, would be that you do only what is necessary to do to accomplish what you're doing at that second. You're involved in that moment, only that moment, that present tense moment. And you don't do anything extra. And I've heard Merce say, and I recently heard him say in an interview, that he doesn't intentionally leave any decoration in there. He sees it as decoration or unnecessary. He'll remove it.
I just don't think movement is abstract. But abstract, what's abstract about it is something you do. And in that sense, it's the fact that it doesn't specifically relate to something, it gives you the chance to relate it to any number of things.
He used motion capture, and he was, I think, one of the first choreographers to put on stage the notion of 3D dance, because our problem with presenting dance has been legion, I think. They've not solved the issue that proscenium flattens out what the dancer is trying to stretch. And in BIPED, he completely solved that problem of being in more than one place at the same time.
I like the way Paul and Shelley used the material they got shooting the dancers or making up abstract shapes, which could be in the distance or seem in the distance,
or close up, even though they were only shown on the scrim in the front. The working out of this was extremely complicated for the dancing. We did, 75 short phrases for two of the dancers, and we flew to San Francisco to work in what was then a very amateur motion capture in the beginning. The two dancers had those small objects placed like 35 or 40 on a black leotard. And then they were shot with the cameras, I think there were eight, and they were in a circle. Didn't matter which way you went, it was always front.
Of how he choreographs, and I think he was using life forms at that point for his choreography. He did non-intuitive sets of choices and strung them together, and required the dancers to learn these kind of non-comfortable sets of behaviors on stage. And what it did was bring alarm to the audience and get us to notice what is usually ordinary and normal. You know, this is how you use your arms. Well, no, not in BIPED. This is how you use your legs. This is how your torso relates to your trunk or your legs. That's not what happened. So because of the way that Merce defamiliarized our watching of the human body in BIPED and its presentation with the motion capture, blew the notion of presentation of action kind of off the planet Earth, I think. And I was studying with Margie Jenkins because she was teaching Cunningham technique. And I was there from 72 to 74. And in 73, in the summer, I went down to Long Beach, as did every reasonable dancer on the West Coast, to take a workshop with Merce Cunningham and Sandra Niels. And that's when I first saw him face to face, hung on every word. I remember almost everything that he said then, that dance is like life, and that you look out at life, and that's dance, and that was his laboratory, the world.